Hey, KU fans, thanks for logging on to KU Sports Extra. Tom Keegan, Matt Tate here at Allen Fieldhouse. KU's home opener is in the books. 86-65 win over Siena. A pretty uneventful win, but a couple of decent storylines came out of it. What was your favorite?
Well, Bill Self, 207-9 in Allen Fieldhouse. He has the record for
nine
most wins. 207, but it's the nine that's amazing. And no school has beaten him more than once.
Yeah, right.
Incredible. You can remember details from all nine of those losses. And this win, what are you going to remember detail-wise here? Maybe that his son hit a shot, a fadeaway jumper in the corner late in the game. Only remember that because it was his father's record.
Sure.
That was kind of neat. But as far as what sticks out in my head the most about the win, I'd have to say that it was clear Josh Jackson is the most talented player on the floor there tonight.
When he was on the floor,
because he only played 21 minutes because of foul trouble, two charges, but he'll figure that out.
Yeah, that's just a matter of time. And when he got his third foul, he was visibly furious. I mean, yelled, screamed, might have even yelled at the ref, but not at him, one of those deals. I think that shows the competitor that we've heard he is, and he'll rein that in, and he'll avoid the fouls, which would be huge, because when he can stay on the floor, he can take over a game at any moment, and you can almost sense it building.
Because he has great anticipation, jumped into a pass, took it down for a slam, and then out of nowhere, he jumps so quickly and blocks that shot down on the block. So
sure.
There's nothing he can't do really well. He'll become a better rebounder than he is
because
he's got a nose for the ball, and he's super, super quick, and he's an explosive jumper. Really exciting talent and a great kid.
How about this for how spoiled Kansas basketball fans are? Two players tonight set career highs in points and rebounds, and it was just kind of a ho-hum game.
Carlton Bragg and LeGerald Vick?
Exactly right. 15-11 for Bragg and 12-8 for Vick. Both were really good. KU needed them because the rest of the team was pretty average, or some of them below average. So it's a big night. I think as far as Self's 207 wins, I think the thing I'll remember, I like the Tyler shot. I like that you asked him about it. That was cool. But the thing that I'll remember most is the way Self downplayed it, like he downplays everything. He said, well, it probably just means I've coached more games than anybody in here. Not true. Roy Williams has 201 wins here, but also 40-some losses. Self, 207-9. So, that number's going to go way higher than 207 by the time it's all said and done, and it'll keep climbing fast. But any final thoughts? KU's 2-1 now. They played Indiana. They played Duke. This was definitely had the potential to be that letdown game because just not as big of an opponent, and it kind of
Well,
was.
Even though Frank Mason and Devontae Graham maybe didn't have their normal pep, talking about Frank Mason, when the game got tight, scored anytime you needed him to. Led the team in scoring for the third game in a row with 17 points. Devontae Graham, 9 assists, no turnovers.
Sure.
So for unspectacular, those guys are pretty darn
good. Yeah, if that's average,
that's pretty darn good.
I think everybody would take that. For Tom Keegan, I'm Matt Tate. Thanks for checking out KU Sports Extra. 86-65, KU moves to 2-1, and they will play UAB at the Sprint Center on Monday night. We'll talk to you guys next time.